for Blumpkin and Friends, starring your host, the Reverend Johnny Blumpkin.
You like that? You like that?
Hey, kids. I'm the Reverend Johnny Blumpkin. And joining me today is...
Reese Heartfelt.
How fucking long does it take to get you in the goddamn studio?
Long enough, apparently.
God damn it. Months and months. You are harder to get a hold of than a greased up dick in a dark room.
Which is basically me. I'm just a giant greased up dick. And I mostly spend my time in dark rooms.
Oh.
Yeah.
Whereas lately I've taken to saying, you know the old saying, sweating like a whore in church?
Sure.
Lately I've been saying sweating like a me in church.
Oh.
Because then that makes me a whore.
It's good. And you're bringing yourself into the joke?
Yeah. Self-deprecating humor.
The best. Only the best.
You've been putting out several tracks here and there.
Yes.
You were recently working on your first music video.
Yes.
Which is a take on Aha's take on me, right?
No.
I made that up.
No. It's about a breakup.
Oh.
Yeah.
So it's not like a ripoff of Princess Thieves in the Temple.
Mm-mm. No.
Because there were thieves and they were in the temple that night, if I'm recalling the lyrics. Shit got real. Some diamonds were heisted or I don't know.
I should start writing songs like that.
About thieves in the temple?
They are just giant concept songs that don't make much sense.
Yeah, maybe don't do that.
Why?
Maybe stick to like the Weezer mindset of trying to write songs that lots of people will like instead of going, I wonder what the artist meant by that.
Yeah.
Because I have no fucking clue what I just listened to for 72 minutes. It was one song. It was over an hour long. And I'm pretty sure 10 minutes of it was the sound of a dog raping a cat.
Sounds like a lot of Tool music, too.
Weird.
Coincidences.
You told me you had something funny to relay to me about the correctional officering field.
Yeah, so I took an Uber for the first time ever in my life.
Mm.
And the gentleman that picked us up, typical, you know, white dude, and looked kind of like you, had your same personality, very, like, witty, cut, dry, like, to the point.
Yeah.
I was like, so is this your only job? And he's like, no, I'm a corrections officer. I was like, no shit, huh? He's like, yeah, fucking hate it. I'm like, then why are you doing it? He's like, because I have no other options.
That sounds like a lot like me.
And I was like, I know a guy just like that.
Fucking sounds like Invasion of the Body Snatchers. What the hell?
Yeah, but it was...
Are you me? Am I you? Are we sister?
It was definitely funny. And, but yeah, he was a hell of a nice guy. And it was my first ever Uber experience.
You said that.
Which was weird.
Why?
I don't know. I've never thought I would ever take a cab in my life.
Well, see, I would say things like, I never thought I would get in a plane and go to Africa because of all the disease and the Civil War and the bugs that give you diseases also.
And civil wars.
With
the bugs.
So that's like something, or to say, I never thought I would bungee jump.
Yeah.
But then I got kidnapped by a gang of extreme sports enthusiasts who put a gun to my tea bag and said, we're tying your feet up to this rope, and you better hope that you don't bounce. And next thing you know, I'm falling off a bridge. And I'm springing back, and I'm falling, and I'm springing, and I'm falling. I didn't die like Trevor, Hillary's fiancé, in that episode of Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. You didn't see that one, did you?
Didn't see that one.
Well, he proposes to her on tape while bungee jumping.
Yeah.
And he dies. And she watches the video. What? He's like, I love you, Hillary Banks. Will you marry? Splat.
Jesus.
You only hear it.
Yeah, but I forgot how dark that show is sometimes.
Sometimes.
Sometimes it gets really real.
That was the 90s.
Yeah.
They were really real. Your hair is really real. Jesus Christ. Look at that.
Yeah. Yeah, I haven't been doing much with it.
No?
Been kind of just letting it do its thing.
It's down to the back of your neck, almost resting on your shoulders.
Yeah. I think I'm going to let it keep doing its thing.
And then until it gets to the middle of your back?
Yeah, and then just shave it all off.
Or you could just one day just go out in like a sundress and see how many guys catcall you from behind. You turn around and you're like, I'm a dude.
Don't catcall me.
Don't you sexually harass me. And if somebody calls you a faggot, go, That's offensive. I identify as a woman. And then you wink and you blow a kiss.
Just to fuck with all the PC.
I had to say that one time when I took the juice to go see Ring of Honor.
Mm-hmm.
The night that Lunchbox had to cut out early to make it to your guys' show.
Yep, sure.
I take her to the bathroom and she's in there. She's like, Daddy, I can't reach the toilet paper. I'm like,
fuck!
She's in the women's bathroom. I let her go by herself.
Yeah.
Mainly so that I could stand by the door to the gym and watch the fucking show.
Yeah.
While she could go do her business. I was like, I got to eye the hallway for perverts. I got to watch the wrestling. I don't want to miss this. It's Ken Anderson, mm-hmm. a.k.a. Ken Kennedy, and Marty Scurll. So there was a security guard blocking the stairwell beyond the bathroom, and I go down there, and I look at him, and I'm just like, fuck. And I go into the bathroom. I see another woman's feet under the stall,
mm-hmm.
and as I'm going in, I'm like, I identify as a woman. But then I saw the other feet, and I backed out. I'm like, you know what? Just hop off the toilet and grab the toilet paper and wipe your pussy. I don't know. I don't know what to tell you. I can't come in. There's other people. If you were alone, I identify as a woman. I came back out. He's like, I identify as a woman. He's like, God, that's good. I'm like, I got to think on your feet.
Yep. Only way you're going to survive in this world.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Speaking of thinking on your feet,
mm-hmm.
I have this topic right here that I've been sitting on for a while. Now, no offense, but I figured I'd do it with Nurse Ashley, but she is 8.5 months pregnant and can't bring her now prego diabetic ass over here to sit in a chair. Her schedule's wicked busy. Plus, she's as big as a goddamn house. The poor thing. Hi. She doesn't listen.
Oh, she doesn't.
I could say she's a filthy whore and she'd never find out.
Watch. She listens to just this one.
Yep. To find out. Oh, he called me a filthy whore. Fuck him. So, now, would you say that you believe in heaven and stuff?
I don't.
Don't you?
I do not.
Well, this is going to be interesting. I also don't believe in heaven.
Sure.
All right. But this might work with us both being on the same page. What if we're wrong and heaven is real?
Then I'm fucked.
I'd say the majority of us are fucked.
Yeah.
But specifically, now, if heaven's real and there's all these old dead relatives of ours up mm-hmm. there milling about,
mm-hmm.
my grandmother could be sitting up there and seeing me masturbate.
I was just going to say the first thing I say when I get there is I am so sorry for all the masturbation. Like, I am so sorry for that. The drugs, the alcohol, minuscule. I'm sorry for the masturbation and sex.
And that time I pooped in that phone booth.
Yeah. The time I pooped in the urinal.
Did you poop in a urinal?
I didn't.
That's very terrific.
Very, very, very young. Very young. It was a dare.
Oh, how young is very young?
Like elementary school.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Was it like the episode of South Park where somebody dukes in the urinal and there was like a big goddamn investigation to find out whose poop it was?
Well, pretty much, because like we walked in and there was a fucking shit in a urinal. And they're like, that's hilarious. None of us have ever thought of that. So someone else should do it.
Oh, I see. You were aping somebody else's material. Jesus.
Yeah.
That's still pretty young, though.
Yeah.
See, I would just like say naughty words and... One time I got caught. Sixth grade, those Mr. Sketch smelly markers?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So I took one, and I went in the bathroom and wrote, fuck you.
Mm-hmm.
And then I told my friend that I did it, and then he went and wrote, uck you, bitch. He left the first F out. I don't know why.
Probably couldn't say it.
No, he could. He could. Oh. But I found it odd, because I went back to the bathroom 20 minutes later, and he used the navy blue one that mm-hmm. smelled like blueberries. I used the grape one, the purple.
Mm-hmm.
Well, the blue one was very old.
Mm-hmm.
So it wiped right off. Once the janitor eventually, caught me and then the principal made me clean it up.
Of course.
But because he left the F, I took the purple and wrote the F and then I left.
Yeah.
So the janitor had come in to change the toilet papers and he saw that and I had been the last one in there.
Oh.
And then he saw the other one and he told me and he came to get me in class. I instantly copped to it.
Yep.
So I would have to explain that up there. I mean, first and foremost, you get up to the pearly gates and you're met by, a long fucking line.
Yeah.
Which nobody likes going to the DMV.
No.
So multiply that by like 10,000 probably.
Yeah.
And it's not like you got anywhere to go.
No.
Because you're standing on a puffy cloud of air waiting for your turn to be told you're a piece of shit. Hop on the slide.
Yeah.
And you get there, he's like, oh, well, look who it is, Mr. Non-Believer.
I'm afraid you couldn't be more wrong.
And then he sets the regular book aside, and then he reaches down and he magically pulls out a thicker book, and it's just got your name on the cover.
Here's all the bullshit you've done in your life.
Chapter 28. Masturbating. At times it was inappropriate to masturbate.
This is a thick chapter.
Like at work. You ever rubbed one out at work? Any job. God, you don't have to say where.
Fuck, I don't even... No, I don't think I have.
No?
No. I've masturbated in a bathroom that other people work at, but like...
It's not the same thing.
Like, I've never, on the clock, rubbed one out.
That's what I'm talking about.
No. Nope.
No? I have.
How was it? What? It's got to be like really, really nerve-wracking. Like, I've only got 3 minutes. They're going to realize that I'm gone. Like
3 minutes?
Well, I've always worked retail, so I can't just, like, peter off and go do shit whenever I please. Like, so they would be like, why is gone so long? And then, like Louis C.K. said, when you come back from masturbating, you just feel like people can really tell. Like, they're looking at you and they're just like, yep.
He just came.
He just came.
I can smell the pheromones. He's sweating. His eyes are kind of jutting around like a wild horse, just looking around. Mm-hmm. He's easily startleable. If you're going to do it, and I've done it at every job I've ever had.
It's a hell of a streak. Better not break that.
Yeah. Even when I was a cop.
Rub one out in the cruiser.
Yeah, I was really sleepy, not in the cruiser. With my FTO sitting next to me, like, hey, don't look. Just fucking start going at it right there.
Hey, just help.
Now, we pulled over to a substation where we could go to, like, type reports and stuff, and he was going to work on a report quick, and I was like, I'm going to poop. So I quick pooped, and then I'm like, oh, God, I'm so tired. And then I quick rubbed one out. It kind of woke me up for a little bit.
And then you were dead-ass tired again.
Nah, I don't get that worn out after coming.
Oh.
I'm not like a 60-year-old man where I have to clear the rest of my evening calendar, like, I just ejaculated. Good night.
Good night.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Yeah. But if you're going to whack off at work, you have to wait until the coast is clear.
Of course.
It shouldn't be like a bathroom where other people are going to come in.
Right.
If you're going to whack off at work, I'm guessing most people that do it would be like me. It's going to be a stander upper.
Mm-hmm.
And you got to lean way back. You got to lean way back. You got to put your hand on the wall and lean with one hand and put your body at like a 75-degree angle so that when you come, it kind of arcs up and goes down into the bowl.
Yeah.
You shouldn't just decide to rub one out at work on a whim.
Yeah, you kind of got to pre-plan that shit.
And that whole three-minute thing, you don't go until you can't hold back anymore and you know you're going to gack like really fast.
Right. I mean, 25 seconds.
I don't normally go frantically just start beating my dick like it's the world's about to end. I like to start off kind of slow and set the mood in my mind with some imagery. Make it romantic.
Mm.
Maybe light some candles.
Light some candles, but only in your mind.
Only in my mind. Mm-hmm. Nobody else can see the candles. I don't go in there like... Oh, there we go. Oh, shit, it's on my shoe. That's never happened to me.
Never came on your shoe.
Never came on my shoe. I did get a little on my pants one time.
I'm pretty sure I've gotten it damn near on every piece of clothing I could. You know, you get the
set. You just jerk off over a basket of dirty laundry?
With masturbation per se, but like the sex, you know. You can be wearing multiple articles of clothing while you're doing it. So, yeah, I'm pretty sure I've came on shoes, socks, pants,
shirts. I've come on shoes, into shoes. It ruined somebody's day.
Just fucked my day up.
My roommate had a track meet the next day. I rubbed one out right into the heel of his shoes.
And thought it would help him.
He went to run the relay race and he said his feet were itchy.
Yeah.
Hey, boys and girls. It's time for another Hey, Boys and Girls. Hey, Boys and Girls. Hey, boys and 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 girls. It's time for another ITradio fucking fucker shitting ass tits beer.
I made a pregnant woman cry at work last night.
How did you do that?
Well, I work in a jail. I won't say which one. But one of the female inmates was like on the phone starting to make threats towards her baby's daddy. And I'm just like, that's it. You're fucking done. Get off the phone. Nope, no, hang it up. So then she, you know, proceeds to sit there and be like, look, now I have to get off the phone. You had to make me yell. You know, you get off the phone. I'm like, no, it's okay. Say I love you. Hang up. You know, I gave her all the opportunities to just hang the fucking phone up and just
keep it peaceful. But she keeps talking and she keeps talking. So, and I'm going to turn my head away from the mic. So I just look at her. I'm like, hang it up! and then she disappeared back into her room. And she came back 5 minutes later just fucking sobbing. And I'm like, you know, maybe if you would have listened to me, we wouldn't have to go through this. I realize you're an emotional roller coaster because you're with child, but why'd you have to go throw gas on the fire?
And the bottom line of the story is he's the baby's daddy, though.
No, because I would have pushed her right at belly first into the corner of a table months ago.
Oops.
That's nasty.
You're listening to Blumpkin and Friends.
So, not only does my dead grandma see me masturbate in this scenario.
Which sucks.
I thought to myself, does my old dog, Jacques, does he take ghost shits on my bed as revenge for putting him down?
Probably.
And I think to myself, that's rude, Jacques. First off, you were an asshole when you were alive. Mm-hmm. Now you're an even bigger asshole when you're dead. You were 14 and you would lose your bladder constantly. It was time to go.
Yeah.
It was time to go.
Right. At some point, you got to just say enough is enough.
And then my mom drove him to the hospital, and then she put him down. I didn't, like, take him out to the shed, like, old Yeller style. And he's my dog, Paul. I got to do it.
I don't think I would have the strength to do that.
You got to put, like a marrow bone or a snossage in one of the barrels, the double barrel shotgun. So when he goes to bite it with his mouth out of there, you aim up.
Fuck, I've never even thought that far ahead.
I just came up with that right now.
That was really good.
Well, if you're going to kill a dog, you want it to be quick.
Yeah.
You don't want it to be like, oh shit, I got his back leg. Let me aim it. Let me try again. You end up shooting the dog 6 fucking times. He's missing now major chunks.
It's considered
body.
A massacre or like a pre-planned actual, like,
yeah, it
murder.
Seems like premeditated. Yeah, murder premeditated. But he's missing so many chunks of his body at that point that he's like fucking RoboCop in the scene where they fucking shoot him up and they blow his arm and his hand and all that shit.
Yep.
Murphy!
In this case, it would be Jacques.
Yeah, it would be Jacques.
Jacques.
He would just look at me. He was just this little black, short, angry toy poodle.
Mm.
And he bit me a lot.
Why are the poodles always pissy all the time?
He was super protective of my mom and then anything that was his. So he'd go, Jacques, I'm going to get your kennel. And you go running. He'd come fucking chasing you.
No shit.
Or, Jacques, I'm going to get your rawhide. I have a scar on my face because I was on the floor too close to his rawhide. And I rolled over and I saw it. I'm like, uh-oh. And he's growling at me like this close to my face, like 8 inches away. And my dad's like, what? I'm like, if I move, he's going to lunge and bite my face. Don't fucking move, Dad. He's like, oh, whatever. And he gets up and he pushes the dog, who then jumps and bites me on my upper lip, and now I have a scar. Like, I knew what was going to happen.
Yeah.
But my adult father, who was in his 40s, didn't fucking understand.
He probably just wanted to see you get bit.
Nah.
No.
Nah, I doubt it. Because I didn't let him hear the end of it for, like, ever.
Obviously, it's still a conversation today.
No, but the next time I trick him into being on the show, I should bring that up.
Yeah.
I'm surprised I didn't think to bust his balls with that in episode 50.
Damn.
Jesus. You ever just, like, pick your nose?
Mm-hmm.
What if dead people are watching you?
Then, well, they gotta be picking nose, too. Everybody picks nose.
But you think about it. Usually when you pick your nose, it's when you're alone or you think the coast is clear.
Driving.
Driving?
That's when I do it, mostly.
You look around and make sure there's no cars that are close enough
to see you. I don't give a shit. They're not going to see me ever again, right?
They might.
They're on the road.
Everybody has a phone in their hand nowadays.
That's true.
They might be like, oh, look at this guy. He's picking his nose. You ever see those people? I'm like, he's going to eat it. Oh, he ate it. It's okay to eat your boogies.
I don't do the eating.
Well, where do they go?
Typically on my carpet. Thank God I wash my car pretty frequently.
You might want to think about keeping a box of tissue in there.
Well, so like I normally do that, and then they all just get used on stupid shit.
Like cleaning up stoplight masturbation sessions?
Now,
I got 2 minutes until I get a green light. Let's see if I can beat my record. No pun intended.
Beat my record.
Yeah.
I like that.
So you get past St. Peter. You know, they let you into the pearly gates. But what if...
Hopefully.
What if letting you in is just a mind fuck? It's like, we let you see what you think you're going to get.
And then they just grab you with the cane, pull you back.
Yeah, you're sitting there like, oh, hey, Jesus. He's like, hey, Reverend. Fancy meeting you here. I seem to recall you telling people that I'm not real and I didn't die for anybody's sins. So maybe these fucking nail holes are fake too, asshole. And then he just starts punching in the arm like Charlie horsing you. Does that fucking feel real, huh? Does that shit fucking feel real? Some fucking reverend you are, masturbating at work, shooting your dog to pieces like he's Alex Murphy, Detroit PD.
Oh, God.
Drinking your wife's breast milk. I gotta admit that breast milk is very sweet.
You drank it, huh?
Right from the tap.
Like, intentionally, unintentionally.
Well, okay, when you have a baby and your bazooms start milking, normally when a girl's on top of you, you might start sucking her titties.
Oh, sure.
It's a hard habit to break.
It is very hard, yeah.
And then you're like, huh, something just came out of my mouth and it tastes kind of like a milkshake. I'm going to go back for more. It kind of tastes like a McDonald's vanilla shake.
Hmm.
Maybe you should start dating pregnant women.
Fuck, now that you said that.
But you got to get them right in the home stretch before they pop.
Right.
Or else there's going to be A, nothing, or B, colostrum, which is just this clear shit that doesn't taste exactly the same. But either way.
Man. Yeah, the way everybody describes it, like in movies and stuff, is that it tastes horrible. But no.
No.
Now you're saying.
Unless you have like a shitty diet and you're a smoker. I don't know.
Well, yeah.
But the dirty bees' teats, they come out like a vanilla shake.
Nice.
Her milkshake does bring me to the yard. And it's better than whoever else's that I haven't tasted before.
Well, get at me on Twitter, pregnant women.
Yeah.
Let's see what we can make happen here.
Maybe you should change your search parameters on the Tinder.
Mm.
Are you still doing that?
I'm kind of like hit or miss with it now. Like if I'm taking a dump and I'm really bored, I jump on there. And then like I'm really waiting for a match and I can be like, hey, we met while I was taking a shit. And if...
I wouldn't lead with that line.
I'm leading with any line that I can that's completely fucked up.
I suppose. Well, considering your profile pic is a picture of you cooking, wearing only an apron with a small amount of ass crack showing. I was looking at it at first. I'm like, huh, he's really... Oh, look at his little butt. Oh, look at how tiny and cute it is.
What's shitty about that picture is, like, it's not Photoshopped or anything. Like, my butt looks super dope in that picture. In real life, it's not that dope. Like, I don't know. It's like the angle and like the way that it's cropped. It looks like I have a nice little perky butt. Yeah, shit's not.
You weren't
like
flexing
that.
Or anything?
Nope. Just standing.
Good morning, sister.
I've been a bad girl.
Really? Well, tell me all about it.
Ooh. I've been very bad.
Yeah, it's nice. I'm gonna do some penance. Take it.
Take that dick. Take it. Show me you fucking love this cock. Take it.
Oh shit, hang on, I gotta go do something. Congregation of Emo Jesus may be seated. A reading from the Book of Blumpkin. You know, my mom had this friend from church, and I'd hang out with her kids. And fucking A, this one time I tried, we were playing Ghostbusters with his Ghostbuster figures. I tried to steal his Slimer. Slimer was pretty big, so, you know, I don't know why I thought I was slick. I put it down in the waistband of my pants, so it looked like I had a boner. This is what it looked like, because I put Slimer's tail into my pants, and his head was poking up above my waistband. My mom's like, what's in your pants? As we're trying to leave their house, I'm like, nothing. She's like, lift up your shirt. And she did, she pulled my shorts, and Slimer fell out. I'm like, oh, he was hiding in there. Ha ha ha. I tried to play it off like, you know, I didn't realize I was stealing on purpose. She's like, you go sit in the van. She made me go sit in the van in the driveway for 15 minutes while she sat there and talked to her friend and probably apologized for my douchebaggery. Fucking 5 years old and I was a klepto. And I it didn't stop there. This one time I stayed at their house for the weekend. And when I went home that weekend, I stole his only G.I. Joe. He had one G.I. Joe of the short ones, and it was cross country, the one who came with the Havoc vehicle. And I put it in my bag with my G.I. Joes, and I never would copy it, and he always said that he knew I did.
Like, I thought he would notice his only G.I. Joe. I'm like, no, it's in the toy box somewhere. He's like, we took the toy box completely apart and emptied it, and we couldn't find it. I'm like, well, that's where I put it. I don't know what happened to it. Got in a lot of trouble that weekend. That lady never let me stay at her house again because we're down in the basement drinking, like, milk. And you remember Schmidt beer? The logo or the motto was Honest is Minnesota, so is our beer, Schmidt beer. And we were singing it into our cups, but we thought that if we put the cup up to our mouth so we could cup the sound, we could say shit beer, and his sister wouldn't notice. And then later on that night, we were sleeping, and I talked about, I was telling some story about my baseball coach. And I was five, dude. I was five, talking about my baseball coach being naked and having sex and her boobs and stuff. I talked about that to this David kid, and he told his mom, and then his mom pulled me aside and said, David told me everything you guys were talking about. I think you need to go and pray.
You're listening to Blumpkin and Friends.
So Jesus sees you. He's pissed off. Mm-hmm. The apostles see you. They're like, fuck this guy. There's a bunch of priests all sitting there in the stockade with their heads mm-hmm. and their hands sticking through because those are the priests that touch kids.
Yeah.
And you can throw apples at their face.
Well, that'd be a long fucking line on them.
Yeah.
Jesus.
You're milling around. You're seeing people like former actress Brittany Murphy might be up there.
Mm.
River Phoenix might be up there. And here's the thing. They say that if you are in any way malformed, or you have parts of your body amputated
mm-hmm.
during your life, when you get to heaven, you'll be whole again.
Really?
What if that's a lie, too? you get up there, and there's what's left of Kurt Cobain's face. Because
that's a horrible image.
People who commit suicide go to hell.
Yeah.
But people that are murdered by Courtney Love, like he was, go to heaven.
Right.
And then have he a giant hubcap-shaped hole where their grill used to be.
Kurt Cobain was fucking murdered.
There's a bunch of fucking amputees laying on the ground pissed off
mm-hmm.
because you can't bring prosthetics to heaven.
Right.
They're sacrilegious.
No
way. I don't know if you know that, but if you get your limbs blown off and they give you prosthetic legs, you're going to hell. It's a sick joke.
That's fucked up.
That's God's sense of humor.
Congratulations, you have no legs. You can't walk. If you try to walk, then you're just going to hell.
Yeah, welcome to eternity on your nubs.
Just fucking deal with it, bruh.
There's Lieutenant Dan dragging his knuckles sitting on a skateboard.
Poor bastard.
I can't even find myself a whore that wants a man with no legs.
You got no legs, Lieutenant. No.
And then you're walking, and eventually you might just stumble upon the presence of God, him, her, itself. I don't know.
Well, no, they say, because like even, I thought even if you're dead, you still can't see God.
That sounds fucking retarded.
Yeah, like, because if you see him, then you just like get born again or you die again or some shit. I don't know.
Well, which one is it?
I don't know.
One is cool and one is even more true. How do you die from being dead?
Do ghosts have ghosts? Like the ghost of the headless horseman?
So I used to be a guy and then they cut my head off and then I was a ghost. I'd ride a horse and carry a pumpkin and throw it at people. And then I came to heaven and I died again. Because, believe it or not, I got my head back, but it wasn't my real head. It was a pumpkin head because, you know, God's a sick fuck. And then I saw him with my pumpkin eyes, and then I died again. Some very deep, weird existential shit.
Man, I will always say forever, you know, I don't care what anybody believes in. Believe in whatever you got to believe in. Just don't push it on me. And when I go to church all the time, because... Both sides of my family are extremely religious.
Uh-huh.
It's always just hearing the stuff, and then I try to talk about it like in a, you know, normal way, like not trying to make any bad conversation at all. I'm just asking questions. I get belittled and just thrashed on.
By your family?
Yeah, they're just like, oh, don't you know? You should have went to church. They didn't raise you right. You should have took communion. Da-da-da-da-da. It's like, I don't think I'm a bad guy. But I might be. I don't know.
Is that why my imagination runs wild with filth? Is because I stopped going to church years ago and I don't go and eat little Christ crackers, the unleavened bread?
Probably. Did you see that article? Two kids in Isani broke into a church, stole the communion wine and food and shit. thought it was hilarious.
I didn't, but why?
I don't know, but I'm pretty sure communion wine doesn't even have alcohol in it. So
if it does, it's a very small amount.
Yeah, like, so there's not even a point. And then if there is a heaven and a hell, you're like already there. Like, they already have you on the list to where, like, where you die, you don't even get to gate. You just go straight down.
No, you don't even, like, sit in purgatory and wait.
No, like, you just fucking, like, dead, wake up, eternal damnation. The devil's already, like, ready to just fuck your day up with giant
dildos. You just fall through a trap door. Then he's like,
hey, how's it going? Remember this dildo? I'm not going to spit on it.
Here's for all the shit wine you drank when you were 18.
Stole the communion, huh? Yeah. Probably should have stolen something. But I maybe should have brought some queso dip, because I meant it tasted really shitty. And now I'm going to stab you with a pitchfork. Fuck you.
Oh, Jesus.
And then all the altar boys that snuck into the sacristy to drink the wine, the holy wine, are up there answering to Jesus one at a time. But they all have giant cold sores on their lips because the priest had herpes. And all he ever does when he's done is just kind of wipe the rim of the cup. He never washed it. And then everybody shares that. Imagine that. Imagine a priest with a cold sore doesn't know it because he went and got a prostitute. Yeah. And then the next Sunday, he's drinking from the holy wine chalice. Because what do? You drink, they wipe. You drink, they wipe. Next thing you know, you got 47 people of your parishioners all coming in like, this looks like a cold sore. They've all got a golf ball size herpes on their fucking lip. Imagine that shit.
Ah, fuck. Herpes are for life.
They are.
God, I hope I never get herpes.
Well, just
stop having sex.
Just don't go to church.
I've already got one thing going for me.
If you don't go to church, then you won't get herpes.
You're listening to Blumpkin and Friends.
Have you ever gone to the Renaissance Festival?
Yes, but when I was very young.
Was the traffic horrendous back then?
Yes.
Because I went a few years ago, and the last mile to get in takes an hour, typically.
You're just sitting on the side of the road, like, in that turn lane, but it's not a turn lane. It's just the shoulder.
Yeah.
And it's just a stack of cars just waiting.
I imagine that's what purgatory is. Purgatory is the traffic jam to get into the Renaissance Festival, and then you get into heaven, and then it's like, this is it.
Do you think, like...
There's, like, jugglers, there's a fairy playing flutes.
Yeah.
I can get, like, a giant turkey leg, but... Where's the knights? They're not... The king's not here to... What? I came on the wrong way? Fuck. See, I knew I should have just done blow and whores and drove drunk and whipped it out on that school bus that time in eighth grade when we went on that field trip to the science museum. Because I'd be in hell and I wouldn't have to sit in my car forever.
My excuse is if Jesus died for our sins, then I must sin. Because then he died for nothing.
You're making sure that he gets his money's worth?
Yeah.
I want to make sure that when he looks at those stigmata holes in his hands, he's like, you know what? Yeah, totally worth it.
All for that little bastard.
That son of a bitch. All for him and his skinny little butt cheeks.
Yeah. Yeah, if I post a picture of my ass online, does that automatically put me in hell's list?
No.
Like, can you not show body parts to other people?
Why? Because I've sent tons of dick pics with my phone.
Yeah, but like that...
Chapter 36 of the book on the Reverend. Dick pics sent from a flip phone.
Yeah, that's the sin. It's just from a flip phone.
Had you had a high pixelated camera, they could have seen all the random stray hairs at the base of your shaft that you forgot to shave off. But lucky for you, it was low res, and you got away with it. Chapter 42. All the times you spanked your kids when you were angry, not just because they were naughty.
Pretty thick chapter.
This chapter ends this book and then also starts the next one. You were kind of an angry man. And then when we get to chapter 50, titled Things I Did to Mom, flushed the toilet on her when she was in the shower, then recorded the audio of her screaming. Blew an air horn outside the bathroom door when she was getting out of the shower and videotaped her screaming. Guess what? It's time to play Guess Who Karaoke Roulette.
Guess Who Karaoke Roulette.
Guess who's going to lose?
Why would you lose?
Because I have every time before.
You only played twice.
Yeah.
Okay, well, the one time doesn't count because you and Joey Black both failed together.
Yeah, that's true. But it was because I was here. I was making him nervous. He couldn't think.
You're like it's the Bart Simpson effect. There's a black hole and all the other kids around him's grades get shittier. They get better as you get further away from Bart.
Yep.
You're weighing him down.
I think that's why I don't have friends.
One famous person. There are five clues. You get three guesses. However, if you wait till all five clues are read, if you want to, you can cash in two of those guesses for a sixth clue that pretty much ensures that I will end up singing a Belinda Carlisle song today.
All right.
Clue number one. Born June 16th, 1971 in East Harlem, New York. Clue number two. Died September 13th, 1996 in Las Vegas, Nevada. Clue number three. Known for music and movies, primarily in the 90s. Clue number four. Shot on multiple occasions, totaling 9 hits. Clue number five. In 2012, performed at Coachella Music Festival, but in holographic form.
Thank God I know this one. Because if I didn't, that'd be bad.
It would be bad. I made it really easy for you.
Thank you.
So I kept it music related.
Thank you.
Who do you think that might be?
Tupac Shakur.
Oh, good. He got it. That's right.
Yay. I'm surprised like balloons didn't just explode out of the ceiling and shit.
What do you mean? There's a blanket with staples in it to keep it up there, and there's empty rafters with spider webbing.
Oh, yeah. Look at that.
Yeah.
There is spiders.
Yeah, there's spiders. There's no balloons. Well, Reese Heartfelt, because you won today, your prize is to hear me sing Belinda Carlisle's Heaven is a Place on Earth. Because we're talking about the afterlife and all the times that my grandma has seen me rub one out. And hopefully she doesn't watch me that time that I tried to stick my finger in some chick's butthole when she was on top of me, reverse cowgirl.
You tried or succeeded?
I got about halfway through my fingernail. Just here's a tip. Don't push it in.
Mm-hmm.
Try to ring it like a doorbell. Just kind of angle it in.
Don't. That makes sense.
Yeah.
No.
Just kind of tease their asshole with it. And then when they come back at you.
Ring the
doorbell. Just kind of ring the doorbell. Slide it. Maybe spit on your finger. Yep. You don't want to go in dry. Sure. It might irritate them.
Sure.
And women don't like that. Ooh, baby, do you know what that's worth? Ooh, heaven is a place on earth. They say in heaven, love comes first. No, I do. We'll make heaven a place on earth. Ooh, heaven is a place on earth. When the night falls down, I wait for you when you come around, and the world's alive with the sound of kids on the street outside. That's fucking creepy. When you walk into the room, you pull me close and we start to move, and we're spinning with the stars above. You lift me up in a wave of love. Ooh, baby, do you know what that's worth? Ooh, heaven is a place on earth. They say in heaven, love comes first. We'll make heaven a place on earth. Ooh, heaven is a place on earth. When I feel alone, I reach for you and you bring me home. When I'm lost at sea, I hear your voice. You're a volleyball. What? In this world, we're just beginning to understand the miracle of living. Baby, I was afraid before, but I'm not afraid anymore. Ooh, baby, do you know what that's worth? Sing it with me. Ooh, heaven is a place on earth. They say in heaven, love comes first. We'll make heaven a place on earth. Ooh, heaven is a place on earth. Woo! How about that? That was dirty. Not as dirty as it could have been.
If I had to sing that, that would have been shit.
What do you mean? I went from decent singing to Peter Griffin singing to a little bit of falsetto to half taking it seriously to bringing it home the right way. Because she is white and I'm in white, and that's how white people sing.
Very true.
From the heart.
Mm.
The heart they used to lust after the sound of black music and then steal it and call it our own.
Yeah, that's very, very factual, actually.
Yeah. You got any shows coming up?
No, we're pretty much clear for the rest of the year, which is kind of good.
To focus on writing.
Focus on writing, finding these instrumentals for the new geometries and shit. I just got to find instrumentals for my Anatomy 4, then I'm going to fly my ass out to Seattle and write it out there, because it always rains in Seattle. Anatomy 4 is going to be very depressing.
Oh.
Yeah. Plus, have you ever heard of Airbnb?
Yeah, it sounds like a terrible concept.
Dude, it's like, I found a place, it was like $100 a night, and it was just a big glass window in a studio apartment, and it just looked at a mountain. And he was like, specifically made for artists, so I think like, he doesn't care if you drink in there and stuff, and so I'm like, dope.
What if other people are there leaving their filth, masturbating all over the place, and then wiping
it up? I'm going to be masturbating all over the place. I mean, I have 4 days to write an album. What else do you do besides masturbating?
Four days to write an entire album, huh?
6 songs, yeah. It's going to be like a little challenge for myself.
You should probably bring some Windex.
Yeah, that window's going to be fucked up.
Because as if movies have taught me anything, it's if you don't clean cum right away, it leaves streaks.
Yeah, life has taught me that as well.
Yeah. Well, I hope you enjoyed our conversation about the possibility of the afterlife being real.
Yeah.
And here's the Shyamalan twist. You died when you got hit by a car crossing the street to go in my driveway to come here to record this. I'm a ghost.
Oh, shit.
Welcome to the afterlife. You're stuck in my basement.
That's all right.
There's no cigarettes.
Ah, fuck.
There's no whiskey.
Oh, God.
And you're not allowed to masturbate because my kids play down here.
Ah, shit.
Just
there's
you.
A punching bag, though.
There's a punching bag.
Can I hump it?
Probably. That sounds gross.
It'd be dry hump. No full penetration.
I'd hope not. It's 80 pounds of sand swinging from the ceiling.
Sounds like my ex.
If anything, it's home. If anything, that punching bag is going to penetrate you. You try to fist it, it's going to fist you right back.
Yeah, I did it. I always punch it when I come down here, and then I forget that I have weak wrists, and yeah, it fucks my day up every time.
Interact with the show on Twitter at Blumpkin Show. That is at Blumpkin Show. You can find us on Facebook at facebook.com/group/Blumpkin&Friends. We're on YouTube. Like and subscribe. I'm the Reverend Johnny Blumpkin.
My name is Reese Heartfelt. Sorry I'm such a shit guest all the time.
Good night.
Thanks, man.